The discovery of the first true antibiotic, penicillin, in 1928 was one of the most life-changing events of the 20th century. Before its discovery, when bacterial infections developed, there wasn't much doctors could do. People died from illnesses and injuries that are highly curable today. Now, there are more than 100 antibiotics to fight the war against bacterial infections. Here is a look at common antibiotic names and the types of antibiotics your doctor may prescribe. Penicillins. The first penicillin gave rise to an entire class of antibiotics known as penicillins. Penicillins are derived from a specific mold which is called penicillium. They are widely useful antibiotics that are often a doctor's first choice for several types of infections. Skin, respiratory, ear, sexually transmitted diseases, and dental infections. They are highly effective against familiar organisms, such as staph and strep. Rashes and allergic reactions are common with penicillins. Other common side effects include diarrhea, nausea, and abdominal pain. Examples of penicillins include amoxicillin, ampicillin, penicillin G, and penicillin V. Cephalosporins. Cephalosporins are related to penicillins. They both belong to a larger class called beta-lactams. Like penicillins, cephalosporins originally came from a fungus, cephalosporium. There are 5 generations of cephalosporins. Each generation covers different types of bacteria. As a result, the class can treat a variety of infections, from strep throat and skin infections to very serious infections like meningitis. Because they are related to penicillins, some people with penicillin allergies may also react to cephalosporins. Other common side effects include diarrhea, nausea, heartburn, and abdominal pain. Examples of cephalosporins include cefixime, cefpodoxime, sulfurazine, and cefalexin. Macrolides. Macrolides are a completely different class of antibiotics from the beta-lactams. But they effectively treat many of the same infections. Respiratory, ear, skin, and sexually transmitted infections. So, they are very useful for people with allergies to beta-lactams. They are also useful when bacteria develop resistance to beta-lactam antibiotics. However, macrolides have a lot of drug interactions. Be sure your doctor and pharmacist know about all your medications when you take a macrolide. Common side effects include nausea, vomiting, stomach pain, and diarrhea. Examples of macrolides include azithromycin, clarithromycin, and erythromycin. Fluoroquinolones. Fluoroquinolones are active against a very wide variety of bacteria. This makes them useful for treating infections when other antibiotics have failed. They are also an alternative when people have allergies to other antibiotics. They can treat anything from eye infections to pneumonia to skin, sinus, joint, urinary or gynecologic infections and many more. However, this class can be a problem for people with certain heart conditions and with some other medicines. Be sure your doctor and pharmacist know your complete medical history. Common side effects include stomach upset or pain, diarrhea, headache and drowsiness. Ciprofloxacin, levofloxacin and moxifloxacin are the most common antibiotics from this group, sulfonamides. Sulfa drugs have been around about as long as penicillin. Technically, sulfonamides don't kill bacteria the way other antibiotics do. Instead, they are bacteriostatic. It means they stop bacterial growth and your immune system does the rest. They are very good topical treatments for burns and vaginal or eye infections. They can also treat urinary tract infections and traveler's diarrhea. However, resistance is common with this class. Common side effects include diarrhea, nausea, rash, and sun sensitivity. Allergies are also common with the group. Examples of sulfonamides include sulfacetamide and sulfadiazine. Tetracycline. These antibiotics come from a species of bacteria called Streptomyces. It seems odd that a bacterium could produce an antibiotic that kills other bacteria, but it's true. Tetracyclines are bacteriostatic, like the sulfonamides. They treat various infections, such as respiratory, skin, and genital infections. They also treat unusual infections, including Lyme disease, malaria, anthrax, cholera, and plague. They have non-infectious uses as well, such as treating rosacea. Common side effects include stomach pain or upset, sun sensitivity, and yeast infections. Examples of tetracyclines include doxycycline, minocycline, and tetracycline. Other types of antibiotics. Doctors have several other antibiotic choices if none of these classes will work. You will find some of them only in a hospital. Others just don't fit into the main groups, but are very useful. This includes antibiotics like clindamycin, metronidazole, and nitrofurantoin. Each antibiotic, whether in a defined class or not, has different dosing requirements. You need to take some on an empty stomach and others with food. Ask your doctor or pharmacist about the best way to take an antibiotic. With all antibiotics, it's important to finish the entire course your doctor prescribes. This ensures adequate treatment and prevents antibiotic resistance. Which antibiotic is usually prescribed? The choice of antibiotic mainly depends on which infection you have and the germ your doctor thinks is causing your infection. This is because each antibiotic is effective only against certain bacteria and parasites. For example, if you have pneumonia, the doctor knows what kinds of bacteria typically cause most cases of pneumonia. He or she will choose the antibiotic that best combats those kinds of bacteria. There are other factors that influence the choice of an antibiotic. For example, how severe the infection is. How well your kidneys and liver are working. Dosing schedule. Other medications you may be taking. Common side effects. A history of having an allergy to a certain type of antibiotic. If you are pregnant or breastfeeding. Pattern of infection in your community. Pattern of resistance to antibiotics by germs in your area. Even if you are pregnant or breastfeeding, there are a number of antibiotics that are thought to be safe to take.